I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
You came from heaven's work
to show the way.
From the earth to the cross,
my debt's paid.
From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
You came from heaven's work to show the way. From the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way. From the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way. From the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way. From the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high.
There is some comfort in this rain. I have been accused of being all wet at times, but I see a few other people who are all wet too. Where was this rain when we needed it last summer? It's nice to see you in chapel at Olivet Nazarene University this morning. We had a wonderful weekend and all of the festive activities. And you are readying for the short run to Thanksgiving and then the short run to Christmas, and then it's all over. And we're here then to worship the Lord. Will you join me in standing for invocation prayer? We're grateful, O God, for the blessings you have bestowed upon us, for the grand and glorious weekend of inauguration and all of the wonderful activities that we enjoyed. We're grateful this day for your blessings and now for this time of rejoicing. Bless these traveling groups of Olivet, and may they inspire us this morning. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated. And will you get your hymnals now and turn to the number that Brian Parker will announce for us?
Take your hymnal, if you would, and turn to hymn number 383.
You are love,
you are life, you are Lord over everything. Alpha, Omega, Jehovah, the King of Kings, wonderful way maker, worthy of my offering, hallowed be thy name.
You are love,
you are life, you are Lord over everything. Alpha, Omega, Jehovah, the King of Kings,
wonderful way maker, worthy of my offering, hallowed be thy name.
You're the answer to all of my problems, and you solve them,
hallowed be thy name.
You supply all my needs, and I call you Abba Father,
hallowed be thy name.
Just in a time of tribulation,
hallowed be thy name.
And I am more than a conqueror in every situation,
hallowed be thy name. You are love, you are life, you are Lord over everything. Alpha, Omega, Jehovah, the King of Kings, wonderful way maker, worthy of my offering, hallowed be thy name.
You're the only God, and there will never be another.
Hallowed be thy name.
Well, 10,000 angels couldn't tell how much I love you.
Hallowed be thy name.
I'm gonna lift you up.
Lift you higher, higher. Hallowed be thy name. And everybody will see that you set my soul on fire. Hallowed be thy name. You are Lord, you are life, you are Lord over everything. Alpha, Omega, Jehovah, the King of Kings, wonderful way maker, worthy of my offering, hallowed be thy name. You are love, you are life, you are Lord over everything. Alpha, Omega, Jehovah, the King of Kings, wonderful way maker, worthy of my offering, hallowed be thy name. Hallowed be thy name. Hallowed be thy name. Hallowed be thy name. Hallowed be thy name.
I call you Abba Father.
Hallowed be thy name. Hallowed be thy name.
I know that you are able.
Hallowed be thy name. Hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed be thy name. Hallowed be thy name.
You're the Alpha and Omega.
Hallowed be thy name. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hallowed be thy name.
For the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Carson.
Oh, I can't help it. I just love it when we get together and watch the kids play Little League ball.
And that national anthem just makes me tingle.
Oh, me too, me too. But the crowd's so small today, maybe we should just hold hands and sing Kumbaya instead.
Oh, either one touches me where I live.
Me too. Hey, you know what? A thought just occurred to me.
You're kidding.
No. Why don't we show the kids that old cheer we used to do back in college?
Oh, they'd love to see it.
Let's get their attention.
Okay. Woo!
Bye,
Mom. Okay, okay,
okay,
okay.
Me, Maha, Maho, Ramanickle, Bominickle.
Knick, knack, knack, cat, soap, fat, rag.
Hobble, gobble, rick-a-racker.
Hobble, gobble, firecracker.
Hobble, gobble, razoo.
Johnny, blow your bazoo.
Sis, boom, bop. College, church, rock, rock, rock.
Two-man way. Two-man way. Join it if you know it. Hey, you know what?
What?
We ought to talk to Pastor Boone about using this as a call for worship.
Oh, good idea.
What's that, Frankie? No, you cannot tell the other boys you're adopted.
Oh, that Frankie's a stinker. You've got 3 kids, don't you?
Yeah, I got one of each.
I hear you.
You know,
boys look sharp in those new uniforms.
You know, I want to tell you how much I appreciate you helping the boys raise money by buying a case of them candy bars.
Oh, anything for the boys. Besides, you can never have too many goo-goo clusters, you know?
Oh, words to live by.
I try.
Yeah, I see that. But you know, that scripture verse on the back of the boys' uniforms, that was my idea. That's the 26th chapter of Numbers.
Frida, do you really think we need the entire genealogy of the 12 tribes of Israel on the back of the uniforms? Gets a little bit distractive when you have to read down the backs of their legs out there.
Yeah, but what a lineup in the first ball game of life, huh?
I guess so.
Hey, I didn't know Bobby Jr. wore a catcher's mask.
That's not a mask. Those are his new braces.
Yeah. Betty, you gotta stop using that Home Shoppers Network.
Tell me about it. Whew. Hey, another idea just occurred to me.
Day of miracles.
Shouldn't we do what Pastor Boone is always saying?
PGP.
Pre-game prayer.
It's crucial for the kids' attitude.
Lead by example. Let's call them
All
in
right.
for prayer.
Come All on, right, boys. Let's get in. We're going to have a little prayer. All right. Okay. Oh, Lord. We know that you are the great scorekeeper in the ball game we call life. And we are but humble players about to take the field.
She sounds like Robert Schuller.
And as we step into that holy batter's box, may you help us to swing hard, to swing high, to swing low, sweet chariot.
Amen.
And as we steal those bases in your name, may we always go in head first and never backslide. As we make that final slide toward home, may you be there to greet us with the words we have longed to hear. Safe in the haven of rest. And right.
All right, let's go, boys. Let's go in. Bobby, cleat tie. Ooh, I sure hope Bobby gets to start today. He usually ends up playing substitute right field. Last time anybody hit a ball the right field, Amy Grant was still singing gospel music.
Frankie is starting pitcher, of course. But you gotta admit, Betty, he's got a great breaking ball.
Oh, yeah. He broke my window and my lamps and my wind chimes. You ought to let him play outside more, Frida. Oh, look! Bobby's catcher! All right, Bobby, way to go!
I hope Frankie's got his good stuff. He's gonna... Oh, okay. There's the pitch.
Oh, he hit the first batter.
Oh, he leaned into it, He leaned into it.
The ball hit him on the rear, Frida. How do you lean into that?
Where there's a will, there's a way. If you had another eye, you'd be a cyclops, That's okay, Frankie, honey. You just shake that right off. We're going to get him next time, okay? Show him your good stuff now.
Oh, no. Here goes another pitch.
Oh, it's a foul tip right at Bobby.
Get your mitt up, Bobby. Oh, look at that. He missed it completely.
No, Betty, look. It got stuck in his braces. See, I rolled it a fair catch.
Bobby, way to go. Next time, use your mitt, Bobby. Mommy paid $60 for it, okay? Oh, I don't believe it. Bobby's leadoff batter.
All right, Bobby, let's go.
Just get a piece of it. That's all. Just a piece of it. Bobby, grab the skinny end of the bat. The skinny end.
Like mother, like son.
Okay, be patient and wait for the pitch.
Strike one.
That wasn't it, Bobby.
Strike two.
That wasn't it either, Bobby.
That was it right there, Bobby.
Brand new bat, never been used.
Oh, look, Frankie's up next. Doesn't he look like his father out there?
Oh, yeah, except for his knuckles don't drag on the ground.
You know, I just love this game, though. The bonding that takes place between the parent and the child. The love and the communication. Humbuddy. Ducks on a pond. Pitcher's got a rubber arm. You can do it. Let's get it in there. Thunder, no fouls. Let's go. Touchdown. The crowd goes wild.
Frida, relax, okay? You've been going to too many of those signs and wonders conferences they've been having at the church. This is a ball game, okay?
Well, at least my boy's not afraid to swing the bat.
Oh, no. I can feel the breeze from his strikeout way up here.
That's all right, Frankie. That's all right. We'll get him next time.
Oh, Ratso Fatso. They moved Bobby to right field.
Oh, Grody Patoni. Maybe he can plant a garden while he's out there. Frankie is still pitching, of course. His father's been working on a new pitch with him lately.
Oh, really? What's it called? A strike?
I've had just about enough of your lip.
All I'm saying is that most pitchers don't need a map to find home plate.
Frankie doesn't need a map to throw strikes.
Oh, no. All he needs is a nearsighted batter and a strike zone the size of your mouth.
Well, at least my boy doesn't ask the Sunday school teacher where you plug in the speakers to the amplified Bible.
Oh, no. But at least my boy's mom doesn't try and poison the entire church with the chili of death. Oh.
I knew you'd bring up my chili.
Why not? Everybody else did.
Oh. Oh. My chili speaks for itself.
Oh, yeah, it's the shot heard around the world.
Oh, I've had it with you.
Oh, yeah. You just crossed this line.
I'm crossing it.
Oh, that was quick. cross this one.
I'll cross any line I want to. I know my code.
Oh,
blue.
Yeah,
all right.
Yeah, I'm going to cross what I'm going to do. Oh, Betty, Betty, Betty.
Oh. Hi, Bobby.
Hi, Frankie.
Hi, Frankie. What?
Who, us?
Oh, no, we're not fighting.
More like a free exchange of ideas, that's all.
What's a little spat among friends? I love this girl. What? Oh, I'm sure she's sorry.
Sorry! Old Frida's onto something, kids. Mom's got to be able to walk up to Frida any old time and just ask her to forgive you.
Well, I hope you boys are hearing what Betty is trying to say. It's like Pastor Boone always tells us. You've got to be able to forget the past and forget... forget.
Well put, Frida. That's right. Well put.
Look, I'm...
Go ahead.
Oh, no. I asked you first.
Oh, no. I had it out before you even thought about it.
Are you kidding? I forgave you before you even asked for it.
You did
oh,
not.
Oh, I'm going to forgive you. Right
across the room. Go to you. I'll tell you what.
How about we're both forgiven?
Fine with me. Okay. As long as we both know that I have more to be forgiven for.
Oh, don't start with me.
Okay,
boys. We got to get in face. Let's go. Heads away. What?
The ump canceled the game.
He did? Why?
The fans were too rowdy?
A bad influence.
Who's he talking about?
Us?
Why, you little twit. There's a good game going on out there. Too bad you weren't watching it.
How'd you like to wear that chest protector permanently, buddy? Why don't you take that mask off and face us like a man?
Oh,
Pastor Boone.
Pass them on the streets. Empty hearts and empty eyes I see.
Each time I look away, I don't know what to say. I tell myself tomorrow is another day.
It's funny, tomorrow's never seemed to come. suns fade away like the evening sun.
I close my eyes in prayer. I see them everywhere and wonder if they'll ever know how much you care. How will they know unless we tell them? How can they believe something they have never heard? How will they feel his love that's waiting?
Lord, I want to go
so that they can know.
Those who call upon the Lord will be saved.
Today's the day they need to hear his voice. We need to go so they can have a choice.
Contemplate, no time to hesitate.
Tomorrow may be too late.
Too late.
Oh, how will they know unless we tell them? How can they believe something they have never heard?
Lord, I want to go
so that they can know.
Those who call upon the Lord will be saved.
You know, that's so true. We traveled all summer going to churches and to youth camps, and everywhere, no matter how different the people were across the region, there was always someone that needed the Lord. And it's a simple fact that they're not going to know unless we tell them. And a lot of times telling them doesn't mean opening up our mouths, especially to draw detail to, hey, you need Christ. Our lives can be such an example and such a witness of love that love can tear down the strongest mountain and cross the raging sea, can clear up a cloudy day and set a troubled heart free, can give hope when there's no reason, because love is the reason for the hope. So open your heart and show this dying world this wonderful invention of love.
If you find a heart in need of some attention, someone who's alone with no friends to mention, take the time to tell them about this
wonderful invention of love.
If you find someone who needs some direction, you lead them out of a bad situation, you'll find out why I'm talking about this
wonderful invention of love.
Love can tear down the strongest mountain. It can cross the raging sea. Love can clear up a cloudy day and set a troubled heart free. Love can give hope when there's no reason. Love is the reason for the hope. Open your heart and show the world this
wonderful invention, wonderful invention, wonderful invention of love.
If someone has a problem without a solution, they say they can't take any more confusion. When they call for help, that's the time to share this
wonderful invention of love.
Love can tear down the strongest mountain. It can cross the raging sea. Love can clear up a cloudy day and set a troubled heart free. Love can give hope when there's no reason. Love is the reason for the hope. Open your heart and show the world this
wonderful invention, wonderful invention, wonderful invention of love. Wonderful
invention, wonderful invention, this wonderful invention of love.
Love can tear down the strong mountain, cross the raging sea. Love can clear up a cloudy day and set a troubled heart free. Love can give hope when there's a reason. Love was a reason for the hope. Open your heart and show the world this wonderful invention, wonderful invention, wonderful invention of love.
Love can tear down the strongest mountain. It can grow hard the raging sea. Love can clear up a cloudy day and set a troubled heart free. Love can give hope when there's women. Love is the reason for the reason for the heart. And show the world
this wonderful invention, wonderful invention, wonderful invention of love.
Hi, Stevie.
Hi, Jerry.
How you doing?
I'm doing great, man. I'm totally rad. I'm so fresh. It's frightening.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm going to school now, and last week was Art Appreciation Week, and we had to do something artistic, so I drew a picture of myself. See?
That don't look like you.
Well, I kind of cheated. I sat on the paper and traced my bottom.
Oh, yeah, now I see right there.
And if you look real close right there, you can see where my shorts got all bunched up.
Oh, for sure. You're a very gifted child.
My mom says that all the time.
I can see why.
Well, I want to play a game.
Yeah, let's play baseball. Rock and fire, rock and fire.
No way, Jose. I don't want to play.
Why don't you want to play baseball?
Because every time we play baseball, I always get picked last.
You know why you always get picked last?
This is a trick question.
Oh, no, you helium head. It's because you're no good.
I'm gooder than you. I can catch with one hand.
So, I can catch with two.
That's because you're ambidextrous.
I've hit all my shots, and I never got that.
Never mind. I want to play an adult game. I know. Let's play war.
We don't got enough peoples to play war.
Two can play war. I see it every day.
Well, we got no weapons.
We make believe.
Hey, if we're going to play adult games, let's play the way all the adults play it.
I want to play Rambo.
I know a game we can play that adults everywhere play.
What?
Rumor mill.
How do you play?
Well, you say something that you heard, and then I'll say something that I heard. And whoever's rumor's better gets to stake a step closer.
Step closer to what?
The edge.
The edge of what?
The edge of this line right here. Whoever gets here first will win.
Okay, well, let's start over here.
Okay. You go first.
Okay. I heard that that all the apostles drove a Honda.
What?
Yep, it says in the Bible that they were all in one accord. And I'm quoting the Living Bible, too.
No, you dweeb. It's got to be about somebody.
Well, how's come?
Because that's the way all the adults play. Now, are you going to play or aren't you?
Well, it's not war, but...
Okay, I'm going to go first.
You go first.
I'm going first.
Go first.
I heard Miss Wilson say that the reason our math teacher, Mr. Whittle's, nose is so red is because he drinks all the time.
He's got allergies.
He drinks.
I've seen him take his medication.
He drinks, Jerry.
We've got the same doctor, truly.
But the truth got nothing to do with it. Now, whose room was better, mine or yours?
Well, yours was better.
And I get to take a step closer.
This is a stupid game.
I go first again.
How come?
Because my room was better. I get to keep spreading them. Don't you know nothing?
What makes you think you know everything?
Because my mom plays this game all the time.
Oh.
My mom's undefeated. In fact, I heard my mom say that your mom, she's shaped like a pear.
No!
Yep, heavy-handed. That's a direct quote from our supper table.
Oh, yeah, well... I heard my mom say that your mom's legs were shaped like turkey drumsticks.
No.
Yep, complete with stuffing.
Well, I heard the reason your dad can't hold a job is because your dad's a lazy.
Now, that's not true.
That's what I heard.
Oh, yeah, well, I heard someone in school the other day call you Shamu the Whale.
Who said that?
I did. This is fun.
Well, I heard it's your skull, Skinny. Your mom's got a piece of hair on your legs to keep your socks up. I heard it's your feet are so big, you look like a toothpick wearing snowshoes, Bigfoot.
Oh, yeah? Well, you're so fat that in PE class and the gym teacher says to run laps, we run them around
That's
you.
Not true.
It is
it
so.
It is not.
It is so. You look like the Goodrich Blimp.
Ah, it's the Goodyear Blimp.
They changed
they
the
did not change
did
now.
Too.
No, they didn't.
Did too.
You're so stupid, I'm going to just throw up.
Just go... Just right on ahead, because that's the only way you're going to lose any weight, chunky cheese.
You better shut up, burrito breath.
Make me lard belly.
You better shut up.
What are you going to do? Sit on me.
If I have to, I'll sit on you.
Yeah, well, you're the reason your mom and dad don't want any more kids.
That's not true.
And then your dad hits your mom.
Stop, Jerry.
But your mom and dad don't love each other anymore.
That isn't true.
And then they're getting a divorce.
That's a lie.
That's what I heard.
Well, I hate you.
I hate you more. Ha, I'm at the edge of the line. I win the game!
Woo! Well, I wish you were dead. Jerry, I don't think I want to play this game anymore.
Me either. Besides, I crossed over the line.
Are you okay?
Yeah, you mainly caught me in the navel.
Did you really hear that my mom and dad were getting a divorce, though?
Nah. I just said that to get back at you about the crack on my hair on my legs. That was pretty low.
Sorry.
I wish I had hair on my legs.
You too.
My sister has hair on her legs, so why don't I? Oh, well. Okay, Sarah. What will be, will be.
That's scriptural, isn't it?
Let's stick to baseball.
Yeah, we got our whole lives to play adult games, but two can play war, though, huh?
Just gotta be older and understand why.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah.
Do you really think that I'm fat?
Well... No, it's okay. You're not fat. Hey, I'm not really skinny, am I?
No. Friends.
Friends.
But you do got big feet.
Without a doubt, we want to shout, God is worthy of our praise. The heavens ring when his children sing about his glorious ways.
But if hallelujahs are
all we know, remind us a way to give him praise, the God from whom all blessings flow. How many ways can we praise him? Count all the stars in the sky. How many days can we love the Lord? Just love him one day at a time.
If we exalt the Almighty in everything, if each of us gives him our all,
if we lift up the Lord for the rest of our days, how many ways can we praise?
From your coffee cup, when the sun comes up, till the moon goes to bed at night.
We need to praise him in all things, in big and small things, and make him the Lord of our life.
If we give him glory as we live our days,
it's no surprise how it multiplies when we open up our hearts to praise. How many ways can we praise him? Count all the stars in the sky. How many days can we love the Lord? Just love him one day at a time.
If we exalt the Almighty in everything, if each of us gives him our all,
if we lift up the Lord for the rest of our days, how many ways can we praise? The Lord of Lords and King of Kings.
ways can we praise him?
Count all the stars in the sky. How many days can we love the Lord? Just love him one day at a time.
If we exalt the Almighty in everything, if each of us gives him our all,
if we lift up the Lord for the rest of our days, how many ways can we praise? If we lift up the Lord for the rest of our days, how many ways can we praise?
Well, this next slot right here, they've called sharing time. So I'm going to share with you, and didn't really know what to say, but I thought I would tell you a little bit about the prestigious side of PR that none of you really see. We travel all the time every weekend, and I'm just going to relay a little story, a typical Sunday to you. We show up, Brian and I are sleeping quietly, and this woman comes to our door and knocks on the door, and she says, "Boys, time to get up!" So, sure enough, we lay back down for another half hour. She comes back a half hour later, and she says, "Boys, time to get up!" So, we decide, well, maybe we should get up, which means I get up, and then when I'm done, I come wake Brian up. So, sure enough, I got up, and I realized the lady, we asked her to wake us up at 7:30, because we had to be at the church at 9. So, I go in the shower, get ready and stuff, come back, try to wake Brian up, he lays it back down in bed, finish getting ready, come back, wake up Brian, and he picks up his watch and he says, "George, look at your watch." I picked up my watch. The woman had waken us up, I don't know, way too early, and the watch said 5:45, which means I spent about a half hour getting ready. I was already ready, so I got undressed, laid back down in bed, and I think we were late for the service. No, we weren't that morning. That night, we get to the church, we set up, we do a service, we unload the sound, we put it back in the trailer. We take off about 30 miles down the road. Someone comes up next to us honking their horn. We roll down the window and we say, "Yeah, could we help you?" And they say, "Your trailer's open." And we 30 miles on the road and our trailer was open. So we politely pull over to the side of the road. I get out, walk around back. We check to see what was missing. Now, one piece of luggage was missing from the trailer. Just one piece. We walked back around. I came in and I sat down on the van. I said, "Okay, one piece of luggage is missing." Now, before I said anything else, everyone in the van knew whose piece of luggage it was. Because if something could happen to one piece of luggage, it would be Beth's. Beth Bimber's. Just because she would be the most upset about it. It always stands to reason. So I said, "Beth, your luggage is gone." Tears are pouring down her face. And she says, I said, "Okay, Beth, what was in the bag?" Everything I own was in the bag. So I'm thinking, you know, her birth certificate, the family automobile, all in this little bag. I never knew. So Beth is crying, and we finally ask her what's in the bag again, and she tells us it's her curling iron and her makeup, and she couldn't go to class the next morning if she doesn't have that stuff. So we turned around, we got back to the church, and anyway, we found all of her stuff, and that was okay. But anyway, to make a long story short, which is too late, I know, we really enjoy representing the school, and most importantly, representing Jesus Christ. We meet a lot of people, and we like sharing with them. As John said earlier, it's not necessarily what you say, it's how you act and how you do. And that's exactly what this next song is about. It's called New Wine, and it's about how when the Lord comes into your life, you have to be new on the outside as well as on the inside so other people can see it.
Well, it's that new wine, the kind that makes you smile all the time. I heard about it just a little while ago, and ever since I did, I just can't let this happy feeling go. New wine, the kind that makes you smile all the time. Pardon my funny grin, I'm just a new wineskin holding new wine.
Now it's not from moonshine, but it comes from sunshine, straight from heaven above. It won't make you lazy, or make your mind crazy, or make you cry over some long gone lost love.
New wine, that makes you smile all the time.
pardon my funny grin. I'm just a new wineskin holding new wine.
Once you try it, you'll have a lifetime supply.
The Savior will give it through His Holy Spirit. Joy like a river makes you feel so fine. New wine, the kind that makes you smile all the time. Pardon my funny grin, I'm just a new wineskin holding new wine. Pardon if I have to laugh, I've traded them old grapes of wrath for new wine.
Hi.
Welcome Thanks. To New Creation Video Dating Service.
In here.
You know our motto? Bring us what you have, and we'll bring it to the heavens.
Yeah, I'm Robert Jones.
I know, we've been expecting
came
you.
In the door.
My name is Buffy,
yeah.
And I'll be your director.
Good, I was going to
Please,
see
have
you.
A seat.
All right, I'll sit down.
Now, Robert, before we get started, I'd just like to put a few of your fears to rest, because most people who come in here are just a little bit nervous.
It's me, I'm a little bit.
There.
I like to be, but it comes.
There's really
sometimes.
No need to be.
Okay.
Just relax, be natural, and above all, be real. Just be who you are and leave the rest to us.
You know, that's good because at first I was pretty reluctant to come in here, but then I figured, why not? What have I got to lose, you know? I'm thinking that.
Like nothing except the totally low self-esteem and the overwhelming opinion that you have no worth or value.
I don't think I would have put it quite like that.
Now, Robert, can I call you Rob?
No, see, actually, I prefer Robert.
Right, okay.
Robert.
Now, Rob, as you know, we're a Christian video service helping to bring all those lonely, unfulfilled single adults who have totally no reason left to live together with other single adults who have equally meaningless lives. Of course, we can't guarantee results, and in your case, I'm sure you understand why. Any questions?
No, sure beats hanging out at the miniature golf course every Saturday night.
You know what?
I was gonna
say. Okay, Rob, why don't you just go ahead and casually chat about yourself as if the camera was rolling.
What are we talking?
In layman's terms, we call this a rehearsal.
Okay, talking
about Just remember
camera.
To relax, be yourself, and above all,
be real.
Right, okay.
And
boom!
Hi. I'm Robert Jones. I'm 30 years old and have never been married. I enjoy poetry, jigsaw puzzles, and collecting wicker furniture. I sell waterless cookware for a living, and my favorite color is gray. If you would like to perhaps get to know me, then just give me a call at 555-3357. If I'm not home, you can leave a message on my machine and I'll get back to you. And also, I have a poem that I wanted to read.
And time, okay.
Oh, I had a poem.
Magic Bobby, pure magic.
one cheek.
There's bitsy, teensy, weensy little areas we have to look at before we go on.
All right, well, let's do that.
Let's try it again with a slightly different attitude.
Okay, I'll be cooler.
We'll start with your posture. Try standing next to this chair, Bobby. Okay, put one leg on the chair, elbow on your knee, tilt your head, loosen the jaw. Can you give me a Kirk Douglas dimple in a chin?
Well, my chin doesn't dimple very bad.
Now, let's undo that top button. Take off those glasses and give me some intensity with those eyes. Beautiful.
I can't see out my glasses.
Can you suck in those cheeks a little for me? Incredible, just incredible.
I thought I was supposed to be real, you know?
Like, what is reality, Bobby, baby?
I don't know.
After the best image for you.
Okay.
Now, can you lower your voice a little for me?
Well, I'll try.
Lower.
I'll try to do
that. Boy, okay. Relax.
I'm going to sit back
down. Don't remember to give me the attitude. Posture, lean.
Yes. All right. Okay, I'm sorry.
And boom.
Hi. I'm Robert. The
camera's over there, Bobby baby.
Can't see it without
tape's rolling.
Hi.
Lower.
I'm Robert Jones. I'm 30 years old and have never been married.
Cut! Okay, Bobby, let's try 29, okay?
What?
29?
I'm really 30 years old, I really am.
Absolutely! Like, you know that, and I know that, but why take out an advertisement?
Well, I didn't.
Let's suggest it. How about I'm 29 and some spare change, and as of yet, unattached.
Well, I don't
beautiful.
Think that's
okay,
gonna
let's
work
do it.
For me. No, see, hold on.
Remember to give me an attitude, lean. Posture, Bobby, posture.
All right, okay.
And boom.
Hi, I'm Robert Jones. I'm
29.
29 years old and some spare change. And as of yet, unattached.
It's happening, babe. Keep rolling.
I enjoy.
Lower.
I enjoy.
Lower.
I enjoy poetry.
Cheeks, suck in your cheeks.
I enjoy poetry. Jigsaw puzzles and collecting wicker furniture. I sell waterless cookware for a living, and my favorite color is gray.
Okay, Bobby, you're fabulous. We just need a little bit more charisma here. Something to suggest financial stability and yet create a sense of mystery.
Well, I'm self-employed. I set all my own hours. I set
dynamite. How about I own my own business, work when I want to, and spend the rest of my time traveling the world seeking adventure.
No, see, I don't think that's where it's gonna work, cause I've never actually been outside of the state yet.
Details, Bobby. Details. Sell it, Bobby, to the camera.
All right.
Posture, Bobby. Voice.
All right.
And boom.
I own my own business, work when I want to, and spend my spare time traveling the world seeking adventure. If you would like to get to know me, then just give me a call at 555-4357. If I'm not at home, you can leave a message.
It's beginning to happen for you, babe. You just sound a little bit too anxious. A little too hungry. Let them come to you. Get the idea?
No.
How about, if I'm out, leave a message on the phone. I'll try to get back to you when I get home.
Yeah, that
Bobby, baby, Robbie, buddy,
me.
Trust me on this one. Women love poetry.
Fuck, bingo. Bingo, dingo.
Bobby, baby, we are trying to make you look good.
I was gonna read
we have got to work with what you bring us, and in your case, a little embellishment can't hurt. Let's do it again from the top, Bobby. This one's a take.
All
remember
right.
To be real.
You know.
Posture.
Okay, second. I'm
voice.
Gonna... All right.
And boom!
Hey.
I'm Bobby. I'm 29 years old and some spare change. And as of yet, unattached. I'm independently wealthy, work when I want to, spend my spare time traveling the world seeking adventure. Hey, if you'd like to get to know me, give me a ring. I'm in the book. And also, I have a poem that I wanted to read to you.
And that's a print. Now, how would you like to pay for that? Cash, check, or plastic?
No, see, I have a poem that I was wanting to read.
Like, why not? We charge by the minute.
Because I spent a long time on that.
You guys take care of this one.
Okay.